golden summer day. Great white queen waiting for them on the other side. She spoke in their favor, sitting cross-legged at her feet in the shade of the ultimatum tree. Sugar water in the noonday heat, ox on the fire, courtesy of the empire. Cloaks up round their shoulders, sticks in hand to leave. The queen said one more thing before you go. I have decided to rescue your people from your king. I heard them cry for help from across the sea. And I'm here to tell you it is time to change your ways. I'm here to tell you I am now your queen. So dismantle your army, let your soldiers marry young, and only go to war if I say so. They asked her, when have our people ever complained? We do things as they have always been done. She said, you have until moon comes up again over this ultimatum tree. Two weeks they walked through the rain back to the king, the demands of the queen in their ears. But the king already knew from the whispering hills, knew a great enemy had come. The great white queen swam across his river in the night, long before the new moon came around. And she marched through the summer grass, dressed red and white for war, bearing a cloak carved from the ultimatum tree. Under a mountain in the January sun, the king beat her back with the horns of a bull. In time she dragged the king from his forest, crumbled up his kingdom in her hands, and she led him to a wooden ship bound for captivity, ship made from the ultimatum tree. Turn home to die. He sailed back the way he'd come. The great white queen, home and dry, warmed her feet at the fire, flames rising from the ultimatum tree.